From the world of sports, Apba Baseball Classics brings to you Home Run Derby, where each episode, leading home run hitters in the major leagues will complete in a home run hitting contest. You'll meet such stars as Gil Hodges, Eddie Matthews, Jim Lemon, Mickey Mantle, Harmon Killebrew, and many others. Hi there, everybody. I am Apba Brian saying welcome to Home Run Derby. Episode 3 of Home Run Derby. It's a rainy day outside in Kansas City, but not here at the Apba Classic Studios. Our competitors today are Mickey Mantle of the New York Yankees and Jim Lemon of the Washington Senators. And we're ready to go. Here's the first pitch to Mickey Mantle. He's going to be looking for home runs on eight rolls of 8, 9, and 1 through 14 of 10, column 2. Here's the pitch to the Mick. 11 is an out, one away. 10 is a drive. It might be, it could be, it is out of here, just barely, but it counts nonetheless, and it's 1-0 Mickey Mantle. Remember, it's a home run or nothing in this contest. 6 is 2 outs. And 9 is a drive. There's no doubt about that one. Mickey leads 2-0 in the top of the first. And 3 outs. That fly ball right field doesn't go. Mickey batting right-handed. We go to the bottom of the first. It's Mantle 2, Lemon 0. Like Mickey Mantle, Jim Lemon is looking for rolls of 8 and 9 and 10. 1 through 16 will be a home run on roll of 10. His home runs are on column 1, so every roll will apply to that column. Here's the first pitch to Jim Lemon. 7 is an out. He's on the ground to the shortstop. 9 is a drive. It might be, it could be, and it's out of here. One run for Jim Lemon. 6 is an out. 2 outs. And 4 is an out. 3 outs. We go to the top of the second inning. Mickey Mantle 2, Jim Lemon 1. All right, Mickey Mantle, the American League's most valuable player of 1956 and 57, steps in the box. He has a one-run lead. Here's the pitch. 11 is an out, one out. 2 is an out, 2 outs. And 3 is an out. So 3 swings and 3 outs. We go to the bottom of the second. It's Mickey Mantle 2, Jim Lemon 1. Jim Lemon is coming off his best season in 1959. He hit .279 with 33 homers and 100 RBIs. 6 is out. 11 is out. And 12 is out. So 3 swings and 3 outs for Jim Lemon. We go to the third. 2-1 Mickey Mantle. All right, the Mick batting right-handed is up in the top of the third. 8 is a drive. No doubt about it. It is out of here for a home run. It is 3-1, Mickey. Out. 5 is an out. 2 outs. And 9 is, it might be, it could be, it is out of here. A home run for Mickey Mantle. It's 4-1. Mantle. 12, that is an out, but the Mick gets 2 to extend his lead to 3 as we go to the bottom of the third inning. In the 1950s, the Washington Senators sort of promoted Jim Lemon as their answer to Mickey Mantle, but he didn't run as fast. He's not as agile. He does hit with power. Here's the pitch. 8 is a drive. It might be, it could be, and it's out of here for a home run. cuts Mantle's lead in half is Mickey 4 and Jim Lemon 2. 9 is a drive. It's no doubt about it. It's going to be out of here. And in home run, it's 4-3. In home run derby, if he hits this third one out of the ballpark, he'll get a $500 bonus. Here's the pitch. 6 is out. We've had a few players get right up there to the threshold, but they've not been able to get it. 8 is a drive. It might be. It could be. And it is out of here. Jim Lemon ties the score 4-4. 1 out in the bottom of the third. That's an out. 2 outs. And 4 is 3 outs, but a productive inning for Jim Lemon. 3 home runs. We go to the top of the fourth. 4s are wild. 4-4, Mantle tied with Lemon. All right, Mickey could have chosen to bat left-handed. This ballpark favors neither a left-handed or a right-handed batter. 340 feet down the left field line, 339 feet down the right field line, but the right field fence is a little higher. Here's the pitch to Mickey Mantle. 5 is an out, 1 away. Art Pescarelli is our umpire. He's deciding the balls and strikes and fair and foul. 9 is a drive. It's going to be way out of here. A home run for Mickey Mantle, and that makes it 5-4. 7 is an out. 2 outs in the top of the fourth. Mantle up by 1. 10 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It is out of here. A home run. You needed a 4. We needed a 1 through 14. He rolled a 4. So it is now Mickey Mantle 6. Jim Lemon 4. 12, that's an out. 2 home runs for Mantle. We go to the bottom of the fourth inning. Mickey 6. Jim Lemon 4. Jim Lemon's first full season was 1956. He finished just behind Royce Sievers in home runs for the Senators. Here's the pitch to Lemon. 7 is an out. Ground ball hit to shortstop. 7 is the same thing. 2 down. And 9 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It's out of here with 2 away. Jim Lemon gets on the board in the fourth inning, now trails Mantle by 1. 6 is an out. We go to the top of the fifth, Mickey Mantle 6, Jim Lemon 5. Hitting home runs is not an easy proposition any time of the year. It's amazing to me that in December these stars can come out and still ply their trade so well. Here's the pitch to Mantle. 9 is a drive. No doubt about it, it's going to be out of here. 7-5, Mantle. No outs here in the fifth inning. 3, that's an out. 1 out. 4 is out. And 2 is out. So Mantle tacks on 1. We go to the bottom of the fifth. He leads by 2. Here's the first opportunity for Lemon in the bottom of the fifth. 7 is a ground ball to shortstop. 1 away. 9 is a drive. That could be. It is out of here. 1 out home run. 7-6 now. Mantle leads Lemon by 1. 7 is out. And he misses. He's pretty consistent with ground balls to shortstop. 7 is another ground ball to shortstop. That won't be a run. But he gets 1. We go to the top of the 6. Mickey Mantle 7. Jim Lemon 6. Remember, the winner of this contest will be awarded $2,000. The loser will receive $1,000. First pitch to Mantle is an 11. That'd be a base hit in a game, but in home run derby, it's a home run or nothing. 1 away. 6 is out, 2 outs, and 3 swings and 3 outs. We go to the bottom of the 6. Mantle leads by 1. Here's the pitch to Jim Lemon. That's an 11. That's an out, 1 away. 7 is out, 2 outs. And there's a drive. It might be, it could be, it is out of here, and we are all tied up at 7 apiece in the 6th inning. 2 outs. 6 is an out. Let's go to the 7th. We're tied. Thus far, all 3 home run derby contests have been tied late in the game. Mickey Mantle will try to break that tie here in the top of the 7th. Here's the pitch. 9 is a drive toward left center field. It looks like it's going to go, and it does. A home run for Mickey gives him the lead, 8-7. 6 is an out. 4 is an out. 10's a drive. It might be. It could be. And it is caught just in front of the wall for the 3rd out in the top of the 7th inning. We go to the bottom of the 7th. Mickey Mantle, 8. And Jim Lemon, 7. Jim Lemon went on to manage. And he managed York in the Eastern League. And then got the opportunity to, in 1968, manage his hometown Washington Senators. 8 is a drive. It's going to be, I believe, it is out of here. A home run ties the game 8-8. And nobody is given an inch in this competition. 6 is an out. 9 is a drive. Here's a chance to take the lead. It is out of here for Jim Lemon. Lemon 9 and Mantle 8. 6 is an out. 2 outs. 8 is a drive. It could be. It might be. And it is out of here for a home run. It is Jim Lemon 10 and Mickey Mantle 8. And at this point, we need to pull out the rotating dice. We'll put it at the bottom of the scoreboard. Lemon 10, Mantle 8, 2 outs. Here's the roll 5. That's going to be an out. But a productive 7th for Jim Lemon with 3 home runs. We had a lot of home runs that have just not been able to string them together for that bonus. We go to the top of the 8th. Jim Lemon 10, Mickey Mantle 8. Well, if you ever travel to Oklahoma, there are, Mickey Mantle's home birth state, there are 2 wonderful statues of him, one at the Bricktown Ballpark in Oklahoma City, and one at his high school in Commerce, Oklahoma. One is of him batting left-handed. The other is Mickey Mantle batting right-handed. He's got some work to do here in the top of the 8th. He trails by 2. 7 is an out. 4 is an out. That's 2 outs. And 4 is an out. So 3 swings and 3 outs for Mickey Mantle. He's down now to 3 opportunities to catch up. Go to the bottom of the 8th inning. Jim Lemon 10, Mickey Mantle 8. All right, Jim Lemon, 6'4" slugger, is looking to extend his lead of 2 in the 8th. 11 is an out. 1 out. 3 is an out. That's 2. And 8 is a drive. It might be, it could be, and it is out of here. Jim Lemon, 11, and Mickey Mantle, 8. 2 outs. 8 is another drive. Looks like the other drive, and it's gone. It is now Jim Lemon, 12, and Mickey Mantle, 8. 4 is a 3rd out. But Jim Lemon extends his lead. Had another opportunity at a bonus, but didn't get it. But he's got a 4-run lead going into the top of the 9th. It is Jim Lemon 12 and Mickey Mantle. We'll go ahead and put 8. This is the last opportunity for the Bronx Bomber. Here's the pitch to Mickey Mantle. 5. Is an out. 1 away. 8 is a drive towards center field, but it's got the depth, and it is out of here for a home run. It is Jim Lemon 12 and Mickey Mantle 9 with one out in the ninth. 12 is an out. It's down to his last swing, unless he hits a home run. 11 is an out, and that concludes today's contest. The final score is Jim Lemon 12 and Mickey Mantle 9. We will be back with a wrap-up. The actual Home Run Derby was filmed in 1959 in December, and it was run in syndication on television from January 9th through July 2nd, 1960. Mickey Mantle in the actual Home Run Derby competed 5 times. He won 4 of those contests with 44 home runs. And Jim Lemon competed twice, lost both of those competitions, and hit a total of 7 home runs. But today, Jim Lemon came out on top 12-9, and we will present Mickey Mantle with a check for $1,000. And for Jim Lemon, who is the winner, he gets $2,000. He will move forward in the bracket, and his next opponent will be Roy Sievers. In our next contest, coming right up now, is Kenny Boyer competing with Harmon Killebrew. Stay tuned for that exciting contest. 4 of Home Run Derby features 2 very popular players. First, from the St. Louis Cardinals, Kenny Boyer, and from the Washington Senators, Harmon Killebrew. All right, Ken Boyer will lead off as the away team. He was once described by Joe Gary Zaiola as the Gary Cooper in High Noon, soft-spoken leader for the St. Louis Cardinals. Here's the first pitch. That's an 11, and we're reading column 1 for out number 1. He's looking for rolls of 4, 5, and 6, 1 through 8. That 6 is a split. 4 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It's out of here. And Kenny Boyer gets on the board here in the first inning. 1-0. 7 is an out. And 5 is a drive. It's going to be out of here as well. That's 2-0. Boyer jumps off to a lead. 8 is hit hard, but off the wall and out. We go to the bottom of the first. Ken Boyer 2, Harmon Killebrew coming to bat. All right, another easy going slugging star coming to bat here at the bottom of the first, Killebrew. 9, and we're looking at column 2, 4, 5, and 6. Are the important rolls for Killebrew. That's going to be an out. 1 away. It's a home run or nothing here on Home Run Derby. Strikes and foul balls are out. 9 is called a strike by Art Pasquarelli, the umpire. 2 outs. 8 is a third out. We go to the top of the second. Ken Boyer 2, Harmon Killebrew nothing. Boyer comes to bat in the top of the second inning. 8 is out, 1 away. 3 is ground ball to shortstop, that's an out. And 9 is popped up to the shortstop, so 3 outs for Boyer in the second. We go to the bottom of the second, 2-0, Ken Boyer. All right, Harmon Killebrew steps in the box. Swinging from the right side, he hits them as hard as anybody. Some of his home runs are the longest you'll see. Here's the pitch to Killebrew. 7 is off the wall, but it won't go. 1 away. 5 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It's out of here for the first home run for Harmon Killebrew. He trails by 1 in the second inning. 1 out. 7 is an out. You hit it hard, but not quite enough. 7 is also hit hard, but it won't be far enough. And it's 3 outs. We go to the top of the 3rd. So some better swings in the 2nd from Harmon Killebrew. It is Ken Boyer 2, Harmon Killebrew 1. Ken Boyer, one of 14 children from Alba, Missouri. Big family, steps up there with a 1-1 lead. Here's the pitch. 10 is fielding column 1 and out. 4 is a drive. It looks like it's got enough, and it goes. 3-1, Ken Boyer. 2-run lead with 1 out in the 3rd. 4 is another one. It could be, it might be, it is out of here. 4-1, Kenny Boyer. If he hits another one here on Home Run Derby, it will be a $500 bonus. And the next one will bring even more money. Here's the pitch to Boyer, 11. It doesn't go. It's 2 outs. And we've had, you know, half a dozen or more of these bonus opportunities, but they've not been able to cash in yet. 6 is a possible drive. It just might get out of here. We need a 1-8. It doesn't quite make it, caught at the wall. So that's the end of the 3rd inning. Ken Boyer gets 2 more big flies, and he leads 4-1. Harmon Killebrew comes up. He now trails by 3. Comes from Payette, Idaho. 5 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It's out of here. 4-2. He now trails by 2. 3 is an out, a ground ball toward shortstop. We're going to ignore the injury. 5 is a drive. It's going to be out of here. Long gone. 4-3. Killebrew trails by 1. 1 out in the bottom of the 3rd. 10 would be a base hit in a real game, but not here. 2 outs. 5 is another one. It looks like it's going to go, and it does. It's a game-tying 4th home run for Harmon Killebrew. That's 3 in the inning. Not stringed together. 2 outs. 4. It could be. It might be. And it is out of here. That's 2 in a row. And it gives him an opportunity to get the bonus home run. And it gives him a 1-run lead. Here's the pitch to Killebrew. 6. It might be. It could be. There's our first home run bonus. 3 in a row for Harmon Killebrew. That's an extra $500. Well, it had to come sometime. Here's the pitch to Killebrew. He could get another $500, and it looks like he is. He cashes in. It is now Harmon Killebrew's 7 and Ken Boyer 4. That's 6 home runs in the inning and another $500. Now, according to the Home Run Derby rules, if he hits another home run and all subsequent home runs consecutively, he'll make $1,000 on each of those. Here's the pitch to Harmon Killebrew. 6. It might be. It could be. It is caught at the wall, just short. That's the 3rd out. That could have been another $1,000, but he made $1,000 here. 8 is an out. 1 out. 8. And that's a possibility, but he needed 1-8. Roll of 20, that's 2 outs. And 3 outs. Killebrew comes up in the bottom of the 4th. That's a possibility. He needs a 1-14. And that's a 20 again. It's going to be an out. 1 away. 2 away. and threw away. So two clean innings, no home run. Two half innings that are clean, no home runs.
We're going to the top of the fifth.
I don't think anybody here believes that Tim Boyer is just going to roll over. He's going to be swinging. Here's the pitch to Boyer, 10. That would be a hit in the actual game, but not here. 1-1. 11 is two outs. Looking for a roll of 4, 5, and 6. 7 is three swings and three outs. We go to the bottom of the fifth. Kilbrew leads by 3. Harmon, the killer Kilbrew, looking to add on to that explosive fourth inning where he hit 4 home runs in a row. Here's the pitch to Harmon. 8 is going to be an out. 1 away. 10 is out. 2 outs. And 6 is a drive. It might be, it could be, and it is out of here, just over the wall for a home run. And it's now Harmon Killebrew 8 and Ken Boyer 4. 5? No doubt about it, that's out of here. He can get bonus money on this next one. It is now Killebrew 9, Boyer 4. 6 is a drive. It looks like it could go. It does. It's out of here. That's a $500 home run. He has $1,500 in bonus money so far. 2 outs into the fifth inning. And it is Killebrew 10, Boyer 4. 4 is another drive. And it's more. Okay, here it's got 4 in a row. So that's another $500. That's $2,000 in bonus money. 2 outs in the fifth. Score is 11-4. 10 is the final out. But the fifth inning is just as productive as his fourth inning with 4 consecutive home runs. And we go to the top of the sixth, Harmon Killebrew 11, and Kenny Boyer 4. Cardinals Kenny Boyer comes back up here in the sixth. He's looking for rolls of 4, 5, and 6. There's a 5, and it is out of here. It's 11-5. And Ken Boyer has a mind to chip away on this big lead. 4 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It is well out of here. 11-6 in the sixth. No outs. This one could give Ken Boyer a bonus of $500. 9 is popped up to shortstop. So that ends the bonus opportunity. 1 away in the sixth. 6 is a drive. It might be. It could be. We need a roll of 1-8, and it is just barely over the wall. It's a wall scraper, but it counts, and it is now Killebrew 11 and Boyer 7. 1 out in the 6th. 6 is another drive. It might be, it could be, and it is caught in front of the wall. 2 outs. Boyer trailing by 2. Or 4, rather. He has 2 in the inning. 6 is another drive. It might be. It could be. It is out of here for a home run. That's the 4th home run in the inning. It's 11-8. Now trails by 3 with 2 outs in the 6th. 7 is an out. Hit it well, but it didn't go. We go to the bottom of the sixth inning, Harmon Killebrew 11 and Kenny Boyer 8. The most home runs hit in any of the actual contests was 14 by Jackie Jensen when he beat Ernie Banks 14-11. Killebrew comes up with a 3-run lead here in the sixth. 8 is an out. 10 is an out. 12 is an out.
So that smoking hot bet has cooled a bit in the sixth. We go to the top of the seventh. Harmon Killebrew, 11, and Ken Boyer, 8. Okay, we've reached the top of the seventh. The actual home run derby filmed out of Wrigley Field in Los Angeles was run on a King of the Hill style tournament. But I'm not sure they entirely held to that because there was some who had 0-2 records. So I'm not sure why they would be brought back. But it was done King of the Hill style. If a competitor won one show, he'd be back for the next show, usually it's the case. This is not a King of the Hill. This is a single elimination tournament. Kenny Boyer trails 7-11. 10 is an out. 7 is 2 outs. Yep, almost dropped the dice. And 11 is an out. 1-2-3 for Boyer in the 7th. We go to the bottom of the 7th. It's 11-7. He's up in the bottom of the 7th inning. He's 3 away of tying the actual home run derby record. He's got a 3-run lead on Kenny Boyer. Here's the first roll. That's an out for the first out. 3 is a out. And 12 is out. That's 7-9 home runs in a row. But we go to the top of the 8th. Harmon Killebrew 11. Kenny Boyer 8. Here's the first pitch to Boyer. 5 is a drive. It might be. It could be. It is out of here. 11-9, and Kenny Boyer is getting oh so closer. Here's the pitch to Boyer. 8 is an out. 1 out pitch. 12, that's 2 outs. And a leaner, that's a 6. That's a possibility. It's a drive. It could be, but it's caught at the wall for the third out. We go to the bottom of the 8th. Boyer has crept within 2, 11-9, Killebrew. Okay, here comes Killebrew in the bottom of the 8th. He had 31 home runs in 1960. Here's the pitch. 6 is a long drive. It could be. It might be. It is caught at the wall. Very close. 1 out. You need a 1-14. Oh, we got a 16. 5 is no doubt about that one. That is well struck and out of here. It is 12-9. And I think he might be feeling the heat of Boyer coming. He's not slowing down. 12-9. One away. Here's the pitch. 6 is another line drive. But it's up there. It might be. It could be. It is caught at the wall. 2 outs. Didn't have quite enough height. 9 is out. But the killer adds 1 in the 8th. We go to the 9th. Harmon Killebrew 12 and Kenny Boyer 9. Kenny Boyer comes up in the 9th with 3 more swings. He needs to hit 3. And he's got 13 siblings, 2 parents at home, plus all St. Louis cheering him on. Here's the pitch to Kenny Boyer. 1 out. We're looking at column 1. 9, that's 2 outs. He's got 1 swing left. 3 is ground ball to shortstop. That's the final out of the ball game. The final score is Harmon Killebrew 12 and Ken Boyer 9. We'll be back with a wrap-up. Home run derby number 4 was an exciting contest, which saw, for the first time, a competitor getting bonus money. That was Harmon Killebrew, who hit 4 home runs in the 4th and followed that up with 4 home runs in the 5th inning. We have $1,000 for the loser, Kenny Boyer, and we have $2,000 to Harmon Killebrew for winning this contest. And we also have $2,000 more for bonus money in this contest. So taking home $4,000 is a happy Harmon Killebrew. And Kenny Boyer, we thank you for joining us today. You gave us quite a match. That concludes a special Saturday edition of Home Run Derby. Harmon Killebrew will move forward in the tournament. He'll take on the winner of Monday's contest between Henry Aaron and Al Kaline. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for joining us. Good day and God bless.